பாலைமலர் நேர்களுக்கு வணக்கம். இன்றைக்கி சென்னை வெள்ளத்தினால நிறைய பொருள் சேதம் உயிர் சேதம் நடந்திருந்தாலும் ஒரு நல்ல விஷயம் நடந்திருக்கு. நிறைய இளைஞர்கள் அண்ட் நிறைய நல்ல உள்ளங்கள் கை கூடி நிறைய நல்லது பண்ணிகிட்ருக்காங்க. அந்த மாதிரி ஒரு அற்புதமான மனிதர் தான் இன்றைக்கி நம்ம பார்க்க போகிறோம். இவர் வந்து 17 வருடம் முன்னாடி பெல்ஜியம்லேருந்து வந்து சிஸ்கோ அப்படிங்கிற கம்பெனியில் ப்ராஜெக்ட் மேனேஜராக வேலை செஞ்சிட்ருக்காரு. எனக்கு வீக்கெண்டில் போர் அடிக்குது அப்படின்னு சொல்லி சென்னை ட்ரெக்கிங் கிளப் அப்படிங்கிற ஒரு பெரிய ஆர்கனைசேஷன், ஒரு நான் ப்ராஃபிட்டபிள் ஆர்கனைசேஷனை வந்து ஆரம்பித்தார். அண்ட் ஐம் ஷுர் நீங்கள் கேள்விப்பட்டிருப்பீங்க. அண்ட் இது மூலமாக நிறைய நல்ல விஷயங்கள் பண்ணிகிட்ருக்காரு. அண்ட் என்விரான்மெண்ட்டுக்கு, அதாவது பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ட்ரீஸ் க்ரோ பண்ணுறது அண்ட் க்ளீன் பண்ணுறது, சிட்டிஸை க்ளீன் பண்ணுறது இப்படி போடுறது, நிறைய நல்ல விஷயங்கள் பண்ணிகிட்ருக்காரு. ஸோ ஃப்ளட் வந்தால் சும்மா இருப்பாரா? அண்ட் ரொம்ப ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜிக்கலாக ஸ்மார்ட்டாக வந்து சில விஷயங்களை பிளான் பண்ணி நிறைய இடங்களில் ஹெல்ப் பண்ணிகிட்ருக்காரு. அண்ட் நம்மளும் அவர் கூட இணைஞ்சு நிறைய விஷயங்கள் பண்ணணும். அவர் என்னெல்லாம் பண்ணுறாரு, என்னெல்லாம் பண்ண போகிறாரு அப்படின்னு தெரிஞ்சுக்கிறதுக்கு அவர்கிட்ட பேசலாம். ஸோ வெலோ பீட்டர் வேன் கேட், ஹவ் யூ?
ஹலோ, குட், தேங்க்யூ.
And yes, and I am glad to be talking to you right now because you've been doing amazing work, and I think it is really necessary to recognize people like you, and because you'll need more volunteers and support, and we're ready to do that. So tell me about you're from Belgium, right?
Yeah, I'm from Belgium, long time ago. So I came to India like 17 years ago in 98 as part of setting up a software team for my company in Belgium. So meanwhile, the company got taken over by Cisco, and I work as a project manager in Cisco. So I've always been a bit of an outdoor sports adventure-minded person. So I was really impressed by the natural beauty of South India, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra. So, and we have done a lot of adventure and outdoor activities, sports activities, all across South India, basically.
So that's the news to us because இவர் வந்து மண்டே டு ஃப்ரைடே வந்து சிஸ்கோவில் வந்து ப்ராஜெக்ட் மேனேஜராக இருக்காரு. பெல்ஜியம் வந்து 17 இயர்ஸாக வந்து சென்னையில் இருக்காரு. அண்ட் ஹீஸ் அ ஃபவுண்டர் ஆஃப் சென்னை ட்ரெக்கிங் கிளப். எல்லாருக்கும் தெரியும் சென்னை ட்ரெக்கிங் கிளப் இஸ் வெரி ஃபேமஸ். சாட்டர்டேஸ் அண்ட் சண்டேஸ் வந்து இன்னொன்று அரவுண்ட் சவுத் இந்தியாஸில் வந்து தே கோ ட்ரெக்கிங். அண்ட் அவர் சொன்னார் நிறைய விஷயங்கள் அவருக்கு வந்து பிடிக்கும் சென்னையில் அப்படின்னு, வந்து அழகான இடங்கள் இருக்குது இன்னொன்று அரவுண்ட் சென்னை அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு நிறைய இடங்களில் போயிட்டுருக்காங்க. பட் திடீர்னு இந்த வெள்ளம் வந்தோடனே நிறைய இளைஞர்கள் கை கூடி அண்ட் நிறைய பேர் வந்து கை கூடி நிறைய ஹெல்ப் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்காங்க. அதுல வந்து முக்கியமான பங்கு இவருக்கு இருக்கு. ஸோ யூ நீட் டு டெல் அஸ் அபவுட் சென்னை ட்ரெக்கிங் கிளப், வில் கம் பேக். பட் தென் திஸ் இஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ரைட் நவ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப்டர் த ஃப்ளட் கேம் சென்னை எக்ஸ்பெக்டட் திஸ். நோ ஒன் எக்ஸ்பெக்டட் சச் அ ஹியூஜ் நேச்சுரல் கலாமிட்டி. ஸோ வாட் மேட் யூ லைக் யூ நோ லைக் இமீடியட்லி லைக் கெட் ஆன் டு யுவர் ஃபீட் அண்ட் தென் கோ ஹெல்ப் பீப்புள் அண்ட் ஹவ் டிட் தட் ஹேப்பன்?
Yeah, so initially there was, I mean, we didn't know what happened immediately. So we heard it was flooding. So it was a lot of rain, but it took a while to kind of realize that there is indeed a serious situation. Part of the city is underwater. So the first thing that came to mind was that I heard somebody saying that behind my office used to be in ASV Suntech Park in Toraipakkam, the entire neighborhood is flooded like 6 to 10 feet of water. So then I was thinking, okay, maybe we can do something. So at home I had a couple of lorry tubes, which I use for my weekly swimming classes. I give swimming classes to some people. So I took a couple of tubes and we put some kind of self-made plank on top of that to kind of make it float. We went inside behind my office, and there indeed I saw that the whole thing was flooded. We went deep inside. So that area is actually close to the Palikkanai Lake, which actually came out of its boundaries and flooded the entire neighborhood. And everywhere we found people stuck in their homes, actually. Everyone was moved to the first floor because the ground floor was flooded. And we kind of started retrieving people which were stuck, like focusing on small children, elder people. We retrieved some pregnant ladies and people who were kind of stuck there without food, without water sometimes. So that went on for 2 days, in which we kind of retrieved some 130 people from the deeper flooded areas close to the Palikkanai Lake to the main road where they could get access to food and water.
This was your initial stage. So how many people came to help you then?
So that was all a bit rush. So we had some 5-6 volunteers which were there, say, which were close to me because all the mobile networks were down, power was down. So only the people around me were there. So again, you need to be a little bit of a good swimmer to go in these areas. It's not just swimming yourself, but you need to be able to
rescue people.
You should not, drown people in the process itself. So we had two teams actually of 2-3 people each with a proper float, and we went to different streets. It went down to late in the night, so we were even distributing food packets like deep inside to people who had been stuck without food actually for 2-3 days, like in more remote new buildings which were newly constructed very close to the boundaries of the lake.
So you started your relief work even before you could, like, you know, guess as to what was actually happening with very less volunteers. And avlo kammi volunteers vechu oru 130 pera vandu rescue panni pallikaranai thurepakkam pagadhila irukkira makkala vandu avanga rescue pannirukanga. It's a commendable work. So did you see people actually like struggling for life and were they like stuck in water?
In the water, not really. People had mostly all safely. The water went up gradually, I guess, so over that Tuesday when it happened. So people were all kind of mostly safe on the first floor or on the rooftop. But being there, they were not able to get to food. If they had food and water in the home, okay. But if they were stuck without eatables, they were actually a little bit trying to get to the main road. But most people don't swim. So most people kind of were stuck in their home. We also saw a lot of animals, dogs and cats, which were stuck on the rooftops, no access to food and water. So that's why actually we started taking out on a priority basis people, three at a time to the main road, where they could also inform their families that they were fine. Because I got lots of calls by even people from abroad who were saying, I'm not able to reach my son, my parents, because there was no mobile signal for almost 5 days, I think. So people were really panicked that something had happened, and they were calling all the time, like, please go there in that road, find out if my son is still okay.
Yes, that happened a lot because we all went through that, no power and no mobile signals, and we worried about our loved ones. And tell me about that, after the volunteers you got, so how did you manage to get a lot of volunteers? And you were helping from a place from Tambaram, right? A relief center from Tambaram.
So after the initial 2-3 days, after the water levels actually started receding in the fields, we also spent 1 or 2 days with the people from the Blue Cross, from Velachery, who did awesome work in rescuing animals from rooftops. We went with them to Kottaburam slum, which were very badly hit by the floods, because that's where the Adiya River actually came out of its bounds, and it was a significant force of water that had impacted those people. Spent some time in Ayapatangal near Porur Lake, which was even flooded 1 week after the rains. So those guys did amazing work in rescuing. They told me almost 6,000 animals they had rescued in the last 1 month since the Diwali rains. And after that kind of initial rescue efforts were over and we got some basic communication infrastructure in place, we started kind of getting into the second phase, which was providing immediate relief to people. So immediate relief, that means food, water, like blankets, clothes, in case people, their entire kitchen household or basically their belongings had been washed away. So we wanted to provide them with what we call a relief kit, like a basic kit that consists of some shelter items, some food items, some saris, dhotis, blankets, that basically allows them to move on for at least 2 weeks until they get back to their normal life. So we set up a kind of a relief center in Tambaram in a big school, which was, I forgot the name, it was a very nice move of the school because we needed a very big place to take in a lot of relief materials which were coming from different cities, Bangalore, Coimbatore, Andhra, Kerala. So we unloaded a lot of materials there, and we kind of segregated this in kits, survival kits or relief kits, you can say, which we send in numbers of 50 to one little hamlet, a little village that got seriously impacted, where 50 families had lost most of their belongings. So like that, we kind of dispatched different sets of relief kits to different locations in and around the city.
Very nice. Because after this daily survival, வந்து ரொம்ப கஷ்டமாயிடுச்சு. ஸோ இவங்க என்ன பண்ணியிருக்காங்க, வெறும் சாப்பாடு மட்டும் கிடையாது, ரெஸ்கியூ பண்ணுறது மட்டும் கிடையாது, அந்த வேலைகளை பண்ணி முடிச்ச உடனே ஒரு ஃபேமிலிக்கு அது ஒரு வாரம் இல்லை 2 வாரத்துக்கு தேவையான பேசிக் நெசசிட்டிஸ் வந்து, அதாவது பார்த்தீங்கன்னா பருப்பு, ரைஸ், அப்புறமா வந்து அவங்களுக்கு உடுத்துறதுக்கு துணி, இந்த மாதிரி விஷயங்கள்லாம் ஒரு கிட் பண்ணி ஒவ்வொரு ஃபேமிலிக்கும் ஒவ்வொரு வீட்டுக்கும் வந்து கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. அண்ட் ரொம்பவே வந்து நல்ல திங்கிங் சொல்லலாம், ஏன்னா அந்த நேரத்தில் மட்டும் இல்லாமல் அவங்களை வந்து அதுலேருந்து மீட்டு வரத்துக்கும் வந்து நிறைய ஹெல்ப் பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. அண்ட் We're really proud of you and
It was a teamwork. It's not just me. I'm sitting here, but I'm speaking on behalf of the Chennai Trekking Club. The
Chennai Trekking Club has some almost 26,000 members.
26,000 people. And over the last weekend, we had some 300-400 people active in segregating, distributing materials. So a lot of people were involved in the relief operations.
So I saw your, I was talking to you before and you showed me a map. So it was very, very clearly like categorized. You had like three places. So one was marked in blue and one was marked in red and one was marked in green. So could you tell us about that?
Yeah. So in the last 3 days, we saw that a lot of materials are coming into the city and a lot of places are getting too much relief. So there was no proper coordination between the relief and the people who need it. So what we set up is like an online kind of map of Chennai city, not just Chennai, but it also covers like Kanchipuram, Chengalpet, Kudalur, other areas affected by the rains. And basically in the map, we basically had visualized some 120 areas around the city, mostly in the outskirts of the city, which had not received relief even like almost 5-6 days after the rains happened. So we sent hundreds of volunteers into the field to survey some of these areas and identify how many families have been impacted there and what are their requirements. Do they need food? Do they need medicine? Do they need bed sheets, blankets? So those things were kind of visualized on a map. So if we find the requirement there, we'll make a red marker on the map. And the map is public. So anyone going anywhere can actually add in markers for help, for relief.
Okay, so tell us where we could find the map. So
the map is located at a very easy URL. It's called relief.chennaitrekkers.org. So if you go there, anyone who knows of a place in and around the city or in other towns which are affected by rains, or in need of specific relief, they can simply click the location on the map and enter your contact details and what is required there for how many families, and we'll be getting in touch with you. The map is useful from that point of view. The map is also useful from an NGO point of view, or individuals who want to help. So they can actually see at any moment of time which areas have been covered, which will be shown in green, which areas are still requiring relief. They will be shown in red. And then we also have some blue areas. Those areas, no survey has been happened yet. So we need volunteers to go to those remaining blue areas and check the situation there, because those are mostly remote areas far away from the main road where none of the relief reaches.
Okay. So relief.chennaitrekkers.org, right? So in the site ku poite neenga pathinga na the map irukum. So avar enna solrarana green color la vandu idu ye romba mukkiyam appdin pathinga na or area ke vandu nariya vishayangal nariya saamangal vandu poi seiradhu avangalukku anga theva kuda padradhu kediyadhu and nejamave theva padra edathila vandu sila materials vandu poi seiradhu illa. So adanal avanga romba vandu smart ah enna pannirukanga na already help la theva patta avangalukku la ipo help theva illa appdina the green la mark panni. So red color mark panna areas la pathingana ad identify pannitaanga and those places need help and idangalukku kandipaga nariya materials theva, blanket, food alla theva and innoru place irukku innoru marking vandu blue la irukku. So and the places la pathingana innum yaarume anga poiittu vandu and edam eppadi irukku nu kuda paaka mudiyala. So vandu neenga kaasu kuduthu dhaan help pannanum kedaiyadhu, even neenga and edathukku poi and edam eppadi irukku nu paatha kuda oru periya help dhaan. So volunteers who need to help and who want to help genuinely, please go to this site and check the map, because it's very, very useful and it's romba smart smartly done. So check பண்ணிட்டு உங்களுக்கு எங்கெல்லாம் ஹெல்ப் பண்ண முடியுமோ அதை நீங்கள் பண்ணலாம். ஓகே. ஸோ யூஆர் ஆல்சோ டூயிங் சம் ரீஹாபிலிட்டேஷன் ஒர்க் அண்ட் டுமாரோ கோயிங் டு கடலூர் ஐ ஹர்ட்.
ஸோ வீர் ஆக்சுவலி டீமிங் அப் வித் வண்டர்ஃபுல் பர்சன் அருண் கிருஷ்ணமூர்த்தி ஃப்ரம் தி என்வாயர்மெண்டல் ஃபவுண்டேஷன் ஆஃப் இந்தியா. ஸோ பேசிக்லி it's a group, an NGO, which has done wonderful work around the city, not just Chennai, but other big metros in terms of restoration of lakes, the water bodies. So these lakes, I mean, the way we have kind of built the city over the lakes right now is partly the reason why the city has been flooded. So Arun has done amazing work in restoring several big lakes around the city, which are very important towards the city. So Arun has also been very active in focusing relief on little hamlets, like deeper inside in the outskirts of Kudalur. More than Chennai, Kudalur has been hit like 3 times badly by recent cyclones. So a lot of villages there are in bad shapes. There are like a lot of villages where houses are damaged. No relief has reached, not the amount of relief we get in Chennai. So our next phase after the rescue, phase one, phase two, the immediate relief. Phase three is going to be the long-term rehabilitation. right? We basically want to adopt some of these small villages, which nobody seems to care for, and kind of direct some significant funds and good number of volunteers to those places to kind of rebuild the village, like rebuild houses which are destroyed, schools, and all kinds of initiatives which will help the village to get back on their feet and go on with their daily livelihood.
Yes, that's a very good initiative, and we've all heard about Arun Krishnamurthy. He's been doing a great job, not only in Chennai, and he's doing it all over India.
Delhi, Bangalore, Hyderabad, I think several metros he is active in kind of doing a lot of good work for the environment.
Okay, so not only that, you're also going to be cleaning a lot more places, and this Sunday you're going to be cleaning.
So we have one more initiative running, which is like an immediate relief again, which is like a Chennai city cleanup. So this is done in collaboration with the Chennai Running Group, our colleagues, the guys who do a lot of running and organizers of the WePro Marathon, which everyone will know, which was recently postponed because of the weather. So Chennai Runners and Chennai Trekking Club has identified 8 specific areas in the city, like Velachery, Ashok Nagar, and other places, where we're going to do a cleanup with some 500 volunteers. So anyone who is interested can join us. It's on Sunday morning, 6 to 10 a.m., where we will be kind of helping the corporation, which is currently short of manpower, and given the large calamity, to remove a lot of garbage from the roads and get our city back clean.
வர சண்டே 6 AM டு 10 AM வந்து 8 ஏரியாஸில் வந்து சென்னையில் வந்து கிளீனிங் நடக்க போகுது. ஸோ எனி வாலண்டியர்ஸ் ஒரு இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட், இப்போ ஸ்க்ரீனில் வர அந்த 8 இடங்களில் தான் வந்து கிளீனப் நடக்க போகுது. அண்ட் அந்த இடங்கள் இல்லாமல் அந்த ஆழ்வார்பேட்டில் எங்கே நடக்க போகுதுங்கிற டீட்டெயில்ஸும் உங்களுக்கு வருது. ஸோ எனி ஒன் ஹூ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு ஹெல்ப், ப்ளீஸ் காண்டாக்ட் அண்ட் ப்ளீஸ் கோ டு தட் பிளேஸ் டிரெக்ட்லி, அண்ட் ஐம் ஷுர் இட் வில் பி ஆஃப் கிரேட் யூஸ். அண்ட் திஸ் இஸ் எல்லாமே முடிஞ்சிட்டு சென்னையை வந்து நம்ம க்ளீனாக வச்சுக்கணும். நிறைய கிளீனிங் இப்போ வந்து நெசசரி ஆகிடுச்சு, ஏன்னா நிறைய இடங்களில் வாட்டர் லாகிங்னால வந்து குப்பைகள் அண்ட் நிறைய கண்டாமினேட்டட் வாட்டர்னால நிறைய பேருக்கு டிசீசஸ் வரதுக்கான வாய்ப்புகளும் இருக்கு. ஸோ ஐ திங்க் இட்ஸ் அ கிரேட் இனிஷியேட்டிவ் ஃபார் திஸ். ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் ஹெல்ப். And I'm sure you're going to have a lot and lot more volunteers, and I would love to join you on Sunday, and we're going to do a lot of work, and we need this, and we need people like you who are genuinely interested in changing the whole city or a place. So any future plans? What are your future plans? And tell me what more you would like to do.
I think originally Chennai Trekking Club got started as like a sports and outdoor organization. But over the years, I've seen that a lot of volunteers who are part of our group have done an amazing work on the environment. So we have a group called Aintinai, which is a Tamil word. So those people have done like some 3,000 tree plantations in and around the city. They do a lot of education workshops related to the environment, organic farming, restoration of lakes in collaboration with Arun from EFY. Mm-hmm. So I would like to see the group more and more kind of engaged with the environment and more social activities like we have been doing now. The floods actually have brought out the best in people I've seen in the last 1 week. And I would like to continue that on a more regular basis, like this rehabilitation of villages, other social initiatives to kind of engage our people, youngsters of the city, in more meaningful ways, basically.
Thank you, Peter, and it's absolutely a pleasure talking to you. And please continue your good work, and we're all going to be supporting you. Any help, just contact us. We're going to be there. Thank you so much. Thank you.
My story.